Wounded Healer Path to Inner Child Work. Part 2, An Inner Child Meditation by Aion Farvahar. Our inner child is not who we once were, or an old memory in the past. It represents fully living and autonomous versions of our younger self. We can only feel as happy and as alive as our inner child feels. And we can only love ourselves when our inner child feels loved. Hi, this is Aion Farvahar. I'm glad you're here. This channel is about self-realization and honoring our life purpose and meaning. If you're interested in these topics, please subscribe to stay connected. Your support is the foundation of this channel and encourages me to create more content in the future. For more information about myself and my life mentoring practice, please find my bio link in the description below. Also, for more information about the artist behind the expressive images I use here, please see the description below. This is the part 2 of a presentation focused on inner child and inner child work. In part 1, we focused on the concept of inner child and its relationship to emotional well-being. We also learned how our inner child becomes emotionally wounded and what we need to do to heal it. Part 2 here is an experiential inner child meditation designed to cultivate a compassionate connection to your inner child. If you have not listened to part 1, consider doing so using the link provided in the description below and return to this part later. Alternatively, if you're only interested in doing an inner child meditation, you are in the right place. As mentioned in part 1, our inner child at different ages can become wounded, holding emotional pain or self-critical beliefs. We can help our inner child to let go of these and heal, but this may require some psychological inner work using techniques like IFS. That said, the goal of this meditation is not to fully heal our wounded child at different ages, but to let them know we notice them, appreciate them, love them, and are open to help them heal when they are ready. This inner connection by itself can make our inner child feel seen, valued, and loved. During this meditation, we may come across memories of our inner child which were painful. So it is important not to feel overwhelmed by them, and instead stay centered and compassionate and hold a loving presence for our inner child. That said, please use discretion and see if you feel comfortable and centered enough to try this meditation on your own. If not, you can always try it later with some help, or when ready to be with your inner child compassionately, without feeling overwhelmed by its emotions. Meditations like the one we are about to do is an effective way to initiate a compassionate inner dialogue with your inner child in different ages. I use first person in this meditation, so when you listen in, try to embody the words as if they come from somewhere deeper within you. This also helps your inner child notice your love and compassion, and realize that you want them to heal and reclaim their true nature, which is pure, inspired, and full of life. Start of inner child meditation. Sit or lay down somewhere comfortable. Take a deep breath. Ask your thoughts and feelings to separate from you to give you space. if it helps close your eyes or soften your gaze to further descend to a state of presence and calmness inside you. Also, if it helps, consider putting your hand on your heart to make it aware of you. Open your heart and fill it with love and compassion. If there is a part of you that doubts your capacity for love and compassion, ask it to step back and trust you. There's been times in your life that you gave love and compassion to others. Today, you want to direct your love and compassion to your inner child, who deserves them more than anyone else. Gather some light and fill yourself with love and compassion to start the meditation shortly. My inner child from my past, where are you? I know you're there in your own world, but I'm here to be with you today. I'm here to find you again, for us to be together again. Sorry it took me so long to realize how precious you are. The demands of adult life buried me in mundane thoughts, pulling me away from you. But now I finally realize how important you are to me. To me, you are no longer a distant memory or a photo from my childhood. You are a fully living being within me. You are the purest and most beautiful part of me. When you first came to this world as a child, you were pure, innocent, and full of life. You brought some wisdom with you because you appreciated life and knew how to laugh, play, and feel alive. You were different from the adults around you. The adults in your life probably had the best intentions for you and did what they could to take care of you. But they could not always see your pure and beautiful nature, as I do. At times, you might have felt misunderstood by the adults, felt unloved, unseen, abused and unfairly treated by them. you needed to survive and had to behave to their likings in order to receive their care. Through time, you forgot about your true nature, could not be who you truly are, and had to become who they wanted you to be. I know that you had to grow through many challenges, at times feeling abandoned and lonely, at times being blamed unfairly for the things you did not do, and at times having to fulfill unreasonable expectations of emotionally unsettled adults. At times, you had to witness their anxious and emotional drama, and even absorb some of these with the hope to help them feel better. Looking back, I realize the moments you did not feel safe or cared for. Did not receive the love and respect you needed. As an infant, all you needed was to be able to be held and nurtured. So you settle in this new world. As a toddler, all you desired was to feel safe, so you can explore the world around you. As a preschooler, all you needed was to be playful and express yourself as a little person. As a student in elementary school, all you wanted was some support and encouragements, so you can develop new skills and learn to get along with your little friends. As an adolescent, all you needed was for the adults to give you space. Allow you to trust yourself. Let you discover more about yourself and realize your gifts and aspirations. I am sorry if at times you did not get all that you needed or wanted in the past. I am sorry if you, as a child, did not feel emotionally safe to be as playful or as inspired as you could be, and at times preferred to withdraw and be alone. I am sorry if you, as an adolescent, were not given the respect and space you needed to find and trust your potentials, and at times felt anxious, unmotivated, and not able to find courage to be yourself. I'm sorry if painful experiences in the past made you doubt your worth and good nature, doubt your abilities and confidence, or become more guarded toward the unkind world around you. You knew a lot back then and had a lot to say about how you felt, but you could not find anyone who could listen to and appreciate your wisdom. My dear inner child, I realized that things at times were not as ideal for you growing up, disconnecting you from your true nature. But I'm grateful and proud of you, because without you coping with everything that happened and surviving them all, I could not survive to be here by your side today. I'm here today because I want you to let go of every negative emotions or beliefs that no longer represent your true nature. The emotions or beliefs that you had to take on in order to survive the past. I am here today because I want you to be playful and inspired again. To feel free and alive again. I'm here today because I want you to notice your gifts, trust yourself, and follow your aspirations. I'm here today because I want you to leave the past behind and come to present. To be with me again. And I'm open to do anything so I can see you shine in your true and beautiful nature again. after these years of separation. I'm here to help you heal and restore your true nature. Not because I want to heal you, but because I want you to heal me. How can I be full of life again, laugh out loud again, and be playful again without you doing the same? How can I purify myself again, love myself again, and notice my good nature again, without seeing your purity, love, and good nature shining within me? How can I feel inspired and creative without the inspiration and creativity of the divine child alive in you? My beautiful inner child, you're not the one that needs me. I am the one that needs you. I'm here to help you heal and return to your good and beautiful nature, because only then I can manifest goodness and beauty in my way of life. My dear inner child, leave the past and all its negative memories behind. Come to join me in the present. Let us create a life that brought you here to this world, a life you imagined living growing up. Let us be playful together and create beauty together. My dear inner child, heal so I can feel inspired about life again. So I can find my purpose and the courage to honor it. So I can connect and find the goodness in others again. And heal so I feel blessed again for this life. You are the one that hosts the divine child in me. You are the colorful sparkles of the divine child, dancing to create beauty. You are the refreshing waters of a mountain river that flows through the desert of my emotions, making it flower again. Leave behind all that is not you. Come to live in my heart, so we can dance together as we once did. End of meditation. Take a deep breath and take a few moments to make a mental note of any insight you might have received during this meditation. Consider writing a few lines as journal entry to capture your experience. When doing so, take pauses and focus on the versions of your inner child you noticed the most and what you felt they need from you in order to heal. If you have any childhood pictures from your inner child, frame them and place them in your altar or living space. If you're open, consider doing a shamanic journey to reconnect with any inner child that was most present. Remember that you can feel as soulful and as alive as your inner child feels. So by helping your inner child heal, you're healing yourself. By helping your inner child to return to its true and beautiful nature, you give birth to your true and authentic self. If you have found this presentation inspiring, please like and share it with your like-minded friends. Please subscribe to my channel and share your thoughts and comments. For more information about myself and my life mentoring practice, please find my bio link in the description below. Blessings.